क्लासरूम टीवी क्लासरूम टीवी
इट्स ब्रेक टाइम. चिल्ड्रन आर चैटिंग विद ईच अदर, बॉन्डिंग वेल, एंड यू कैन सी they seem to be having fun together, smiling, laughing, chatting. What a wonderful scene. They are all very happy, aren't they? There seems to be no limits for their chatting and happiness. Wow! Bell rang for the next class. The small break before the next class was enough for the children. They moved around and started chatting. The mandatory 5 minutes was over and the teacher did not come. The children started wondering.
Ramya, do you think Janaki teacher is absent?
How do I know?
Ramya was looking out of the classroom for the teacher.
Ekat sari teacher.
Very nice. So beautiful.
Look here teacher.
Very nice. Nice colors. Beautiful.
Okay teacher.
Suddenly, they noticed the teacher carrying bundles of cloth walking towards the class. A few of them dashed to help her. They all liked Janaki teacher as she was fair to everyone and was never partial to one student.
Okay, children, good morning,
Sira.
Thank you, teacher.
The brilliant red and black checked rumals, shawls with black and blue geometric patterns caught the attention of the class as the teacher handed over the material to the eager helpers. She pinned them neatly on the soft board and the drab class suddenly looked vibrant.
Teacher, what are these fabrics? Why did you bring them?
Wait, I will explain you. Look at the blackboard.
Shweta, what is that new word?
I don't know.
I know this word.
What?
Telangana.
Telangana of India.
You are right.
I got.
Stop, stop, I will tell you. I K A T I as in it. K as in Kamala. T as TH in both.
Children, ikat is an Indonesian term meaning bind or knot.
The class fell silent. Ramya asked,
Teacher, are these fabrics from Indonesia?
The teacher shook her head and said,
Children, can anyone remember seeing designs like this?
Raghav said,
Teacher, the pattern on the rumal is similar to the one on my mother's sari, though the colors are not the same.
Yes. Can anyone tell me the name of the place? It is close to our state capital. There, I gave you a clue.
Teacher.
Karimnagar.
Karnool.
Nalagonda.
Correct.
It's Pochampalli village in Nalgonda district.
Teacher, we forgot we could not live. We all know Pochampalli.
Pochampalli is correct.
Why? Let me tell you the story of Ikat. It is about our handloom.
Teacher,
tell Ahmed.
What are handlooms?
Ahmed was the first to voice the question in everyone's mind. The teacher gazed around the class and said,
A hand-operated loom which weaves and has been weaving fabrics for centuries. In the race with the machine, we have forgotten our heritage.
She fell silent and the children recognized her pensive mood and kept silent. Someone hesitantly asked,
Teacher, you mentioned the story of Ikat.
Yes, teacher.
It is called Chitki in Telugu, Patola in Gujarati, simply Ikat in Oriya.
Children's attention was divided between her words and the fabrics as she opened a silk patola sari from Patan, Gujarat. It had a red design on a black background with rows of flowers in the border. The simple leaf design repeated across the body and the flowers in the border created a mesmerizing effect.
Are you thinking about the word of Ikat, then tie and dye while you are looking at the fabrics? What can be the origin of this word?
No one answered but looked expectantly as she continued.
In hand weaving, we have threads stretched lengthwise called warp and threads intersecting them widthwise called weft. Imagine the graph sheet and the x-axis and the y-axis and how they crisscross to form square motifs.
Lengthwise warp, widthwise weft. Did you understand, children?
Yes, teacher.
Ahmed was excited.
Teacher. Warp is on y-axis, weft is on x-axis.
Yes.
In Icat, the threads are carefully sorted, warp and weft divided into bundles, then tied with locally available waterproof materials like plastic sheets and rubber strips from car and bicycle tires, then dropped into color. Once you untie the knots, you can see white threads dotted with color at intervals.
Teacher, how do you know where to tie the knots?
Janaki smiled.
The ties indicate the design we want. We can look at a design or motif and a tie.
Ravi looked puzzled. It did not seem simple.
Teacher, a design or a motif and a tie.
Ravi, you are absolutely right.
It is not easy. First, you count the threads, measure the distance, calculate when to repeat a pattern. Only then you can tie the knots.
Teacher, it seems like difficult knots. Correct.
Weavers may not be formally educated but have complex calculations at their fingertips. They draw patterns on the graphs and copy them on the threads. Just close your eyes and imagine threads stretched out long with dots of different colors shining. I have seen such a sight in villages of Nalgonda.
Teacher, the dots are like raindrops, chukka, that is how the name of Chitiki Ruma.
This was the favorite headgears of fishermen and other laborers.
It was also the turban on shoulders of traders in Gujarat.
She suddenly thought of another explanation.
Yes, children. When you have to measure a small quantity of a material, you use a specific word in Telugu.
This time, Ramya answered promptly.
Teacher,
Chitikaru. Yes, teacher. Yes, 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 yes. Teacher, the meaning is here. Please read.
Chitiki means small and small dots of color which are characteristic of Icat.
The class was jubilant. They were able to come up with an original explanation for a historical phrase.
When trade was vigorous with other nations in Southeast Asia, tie and dye or chitki, as lengths of fabric was a favorite export item, both in silk and cotton. There are other interesting stories on ikat. Different regions fight about its origin. Did it travel from Gujarat to the south or vice versa? Did it first originate in the coastal belt of Andhra Pradesh and travel to Nalgonda? There is no systematic historical documentation to resolve this dispute.
The class was fully attentive now.
For Raksha Bandhan, the tying of the knot was done by yellow and red ikat dyeing threads. In our tradition, tying the knot was sacred. Maybe this has a relation to tying and dyeing process. But in parts of Gujarat, Maharashtra and Deccan, designs in ikat were very much influenced by Muslim culture.
The lesson is super, teacher. Thank you very much, teacher.
Thank you very much, teacher.
Okay, children, welcome. You can see there. So, children.
The bell was ringing, but the class was lost in a period where vibrant colors and compelling stories were woven into beautiful fabrics. Please like, share, subscribe and hit bell icon for notifications from Classroom TV.